Assalamualaikum, my name is Zidane Hamid and I'm 9 years old, and today is episode number 3 of Cricket with Zidane and Malik, the Big Bash League. With me over here is Malik, Malik, sports professional sports commentator in Ireland. How are you?
I'm good, how about you?
People, I'm also fine.
Today we are going to talk about the Big Bash and especially match 32. Melbourne Renegades beat Sydney Sixers comprehensively. We're going to talk about that game. Zizu, did you watch that match?
Of course I watched that match. I loved it a lot. First, you see, the Big Bash League has been, this was my most peculiar Big Bash League ever. Well, we've seen something really tough to believe. Hobart Hurricanes, their team, who haven't won the Big Bash League since the 12 years it started, not even came in the final. Their best was number 4. They are on number 1, played 7, won 6, lost 1. Then after that, the Melbourne Renegades, the Sydney Thunder, the Adelaide Strikers, then the Sydney Sixers coming on number 5. Then after that, which is really intriguing, Brisbane Heat, Perth Scorchers, the most successful team in the BBL ever. And after that, and the last is Melbourne Stars after the defeat to Hobart Hurricanes. Well, if you see, it has been really good in the Big Bash League, and we have seen many teams competing for the first position, and Hobart Hurricanes are really on it. So this time, in the match with Melbourne Renegades and Sydney Thunder won 15 for 9, Melbourne Renegades won 16 for 3, they won the match by 7 wickets. Well, we've seen over here that the top order batsmen were demolished in the Sydney Sixers batting order, and they were 47 in 10 overs. But they could have made less than 120 overs. But after that, a tail-ender, Tom Curran, he's a tail-ender, he made 44 runs. What do you say about that?
That is just most surprising. And it's, good to another angle if you see that a tail-ender going on to make 40 odd runs, which means that the pitch is not the thing to blame for the players. So it was playing pretty handsomely, it was playing good, it was more like a cracker for my liking, but it were, you know, the self-destruction by the Sydney Sixers, which was made to fall by the bowling of Richardson and Mohammad Nabi. And I think the off-spin of Mohammad Nabi was absolutely very variable for the Sixers.
Well, we've seen where Ken Richardson and Mohammad Nabi sharing 7 wickets. That was the most needed breakthrough, the last straw over there. And the Tom Curran 44 reminded me of Mujibur Rahman. He's a number 11 for the Brisbane Heat, making 39 runs, the second largest score by, is the first largest score by number 11. No number 11 has made 39 runs. Well, you can see his impressive backflip.
Chipping in with these sort of performances, which really, you know, is at times incredible as well and interesting as well. But your tailenders should have a taste of batting as well. That is another option. That is something, you know, just inspiring tailenders to put on some show with the bat as well, and they can do the job as well, and they are doing it these days, especially in the Big Bash. And I've got experts sitting next to me who knows more about Big Bash, and boy, he's pumped up today. And talking about Hobart Hurricanes,
yes,
in the last 12 years they haven't been able to go to the finals even, and now they're almost unbeaten, have lost only one game out of 7 they've played. Just put some dissection on their performance in the latest Big Bash.
Well, they've been really good. I think they've got some motivation to them that what happens if we lose 12? In the 13th, we might win, and they've just got the same thing right now. Well, I think two players which can get man of the series, if they go in form, Matthew Wade or Josh Short. And you see, in the match against Melbourne Stars, they made 185 for 2. We've seen great 96 by Darcy Short. That's the big juicy part. Then Matthew Wade chiming in with a little 41. And after that, Benjamin McDermott putting the final touches with a little 21 of 10 balls, which made them a big mammoth target. Melbourne Stars way back, out for 126. But we still see strong teams like the Sydney Thunder, the Adelaide Strikers, they've been really good. And most notable, the Melbourne Renegades.
And don't forget Perth Scorchers as well, they will be the underdogs.
Nah. They are on the seventh position. They have
they
lost
are right
three.
Now, but I can tell you they can bounce back as India have done against Australia in the current series going on. But anyway, we were talking about the Big Bash, and in this Big Bash, you were talking about, I mean, the Hobart Hurricanes. They've got a number of players who are, you know, the strong contenders for the man of the series as well. And if you have, you know, people like who are about to, you know, winning the title for themselves for man of the series, then you are obviously going to come in front. You are on the driver's seat as compared to the other teams, and this is what is happening to Hobart Hurricanes. And I think his favorite team is that as well, my commentators, Zizou's Hobart Hurricanes, because we should feel for them as well, because they fight it pretty hard in the last 12 seasons, and now this is the time, and this is, I think, the ticket for them to make it to the finals.
Yes, but anything can happen. We still have
they've got still 5 games left, you know, 12 games to be played, and they've played 7, and so far so good.
Well,
they're on the road.
Yes, that's what I'm talking about. But anything can happen. We still have a month of Big Bash remaining. We can have Sydney Thunder number 1, Sydney Sixers coming in. Sydney Thunder are on the tail of Hobart Hurricanes. They win one match and win 2 more matches, they can overtake Hobart Hurricanes. But it's still impossible because Hobart are constantly winning. And they have a game against Perth Scorchers and tomorrow. And who knows? So far, so good.
Yeah, but who knows? You know, even Sydney Sixers and Perth Scorchers could lead the table at the end of the day.
Or Sydney Thunder or Melbourne Renegades.
Yeah, there's still a lot to go in the Big Bash, but at the moment, you know, it's going great guns for Hobart Hurricanes. And Zizou, what about Richardson taking only wickets, you know, in the last match number 32. He was absolutely a great bowler, and he was tough to handle for the players of Sydney Sixers.
Yes, I mean, a spinner and a fast bowler, really good combination.
That really was great, and that was obviously unplayable at the end of the day for Sydney Sixers, and that was brought about the downfall. And in the end, they've lost that match. And Hobart Hurricanes flying high.
But they're hurricaning everybody else.
They are obviously. And Scorchers.
Hey, correction. You said Hobart Hurricanes. You're Melbourne Renegades. Renegades, okay, just forget.
They were Renegades, but I'm worried a little bit about Scorchers, but they are far better team than they are. Their stats don't suggest, you know, the quality and the potential that they possess, but who knows? They can bounce back. They have the ability to do that.
The Melbourne Stars, they're shining at Perth. They were number 5 once. They're going to number 8. Well, I mean, I didn't even think that they would go down than Perth Scorchers. But so far, it's just like the road to winning for Hobart Hurricanes. I mean, you can feel that when something is, you know, you watch it desperately, and after it comes, you might know what it means. But right now, we still have fierce competitors coming in. Even the Hobart Hurricanes have good players and overseas players too. There are still the Melbourne Renegades. They are also having good players. Adelaide Strikers, they have been working tirelessly in the BBL. And they won the title last year. What got them to win the title last year was to play good, you know, keep it safe, keep it cool. They were just like this last year, and then they just went it.
You mean to say their combination, and it was absolutely devastating for the rest of the teams last year. That's why they won the title at the end of the season. But now I think we got to talk about a little bit of Dwayne Bravo as well.
His team is on number 8. Think about that.
But he hasn't been able to put an impact, which was, you know, expected of him, the kind of caliber he possesses in the world cricket. He's a very, you know, dashy all-rounder, and he can, you know, change the complexion of the game on his own. He can turn the game on his own. He's got the potential, but hasn't been able to click in the Big Bash.
Yes, but I mean, his batting couldn't click off in the number 4, but his fast bowling was really good. He got, you know, like...
Yeah, he experiments a little bit too much with the ball. He's a very tough bowler to face for any batsman in any format, because he has got, you know, a very good slow ball, which can deceive even the best in the business.
I was swing too.
Yeah, and he's an exponent of reverse swing, and he's has the knack of picking up wickets. That's why he's, that makes him a very tough customer as an all-rounder.
Well, he's already shown it with that 3 for 19. Here's something I want to tell you. In the last BBL, in the semi-final, number 4 were Hobart Hurricanes. and they got out for 99 in, you know, their qualifier. They got out for 99 in the first quarterfinal. I mean, what was that? 99 runs, Hopper Hurricanes all out. And you know, Melbourne Renegades one day, I mean, it was a really rare match, which is very rare of them to see against the Sydney Sixers. The Sydney Sixers made 132 runs, easy target, right? But you know, you've seen that match with Dawn Pro Rajashi against Gaka Gladiators yesterday. They made 102 and chased for 136. Well, that also happened. But Melbourne Renegades, they totally just got out, which led them to the fifth position from number 2 to 5.
It's too tough to match you, Zizou, in a split seat, in a split second. I can tell you people, this guy is taking off to Australia from Pakistan, and all of a sudden, he's taking another flight to
Bangladesh
as well. Hard stopping you. But anyway, this is what we were meant about, and this is what it was in this episode, especially to talk about the BBL season 2019. And I hope that you would have enjoyed our today's episode. We will join you with the next episode. Head back again, stay tuned to us in this chat with Zidane and Malik. Anyway,